Alrighty you guys, so this video is going to be all about installing the quick weave, and I'll be showing you the products I'll be using, which will be elastic bands for my leave out portion temporarily, and then also a wig cap. And then I'll also be using the protective shield, the black color, just to protect my hair underneath the leave out, and some bonding glue. And then I'll also be using Got To Be Glued to hold down my hair so that it'll lay flat. And then my Karakare wax stick I'll be using for my leave out portion when I get to flat ironing, once I get my leave out or all the tracks installed. And so the hair I will be using today is the Sensual Collection Mink Yaki in a 12 inch and a 10 inch, color 1B. And I'm gonna start off by parting my hair to where I would like my part to be at. And it's kind of where I don't really want a middle part and not too much of a side part, but slightly in between. Like, I normally would try to look at my eyebrow, like determine from there and do like a slanted part, just to, so I will have a little bit more of hair as a bang section in the front and not too much in, that's blocking my eye on whichever side I'm going to decide to put the have more hair on. Or a bang, kind of, sort of, if that makes sense. But yeah, you can pretty much play around with it however you like. But I am leaving some hair on the sides to give it more of a natural look for when I go in and install it, that it'll be more of a natural look if I wanted to pull the hair behind my ear. All right, so next I'm going to be using the Eco Styling Gel to mold my hair down in the back. I'll be using the Eco Styling Gel along with Got To Be Glued Spray, just to create that firm hold underneath my stocking cap so that my quick weave will lay flatly. And so I couldn't find my bigger brush, so I had to use the small brush here, but it'll work for the time being. But I'm just going in with my Got To Be Glued Spray. And you guys, I had a bit of trouble. It wasn't working for me at first because I had buildup around it, so I just cleared that up and now it's working. And just spraying a generous amount over where I applied the gel, all the way on the back. And then I'm going to come in and brush to where I can get it to lay down flatly before I go in with a blow dryer to get it to hold. So I'm going in with my blow dryer and getting that mold to hold down. And as you can see, that my hair in the back was giving me pretty much a hard time. It kept flaring up in the back and that was kind of frustrating me, but what I just decided to do is go back in with some more Got To Be Glued Spray to kind of help it out and try to get it to stay down. But of course, it's still giving me some issues, but I'm not too much worried about my hair in the back. I mean, it's going to do its thing or do whatever it wants to do, as long as it's just laying flat on more of the portion in the front, then I'm okay with that. All right, so now we're ready for the stocking cap. I'm going to be using this white pencil here, this marking pencil. But I did later on come in with a piece of chalk that I had around the house because the pencil wasn't working too well for me. But you'll see further in the video where I changed from what I marked the stocking cap with for where my leave out will be at. So I'm going to apply the stocking cap on and just making sure that it's snug around where my area of my hair is, where I mold it down. And it's going to stay in place for you guys, because especially once I go in to apply more of the Got To Be Glue on top of the stocking cap to kind of hold around the leave out. So this pencil, like I stated before, it wasn't working for me. And so that's why I just decided to kind of switch up and go in with a piece of chalk to make it more where I can see where I marked my leave out at. So this is where I went and used the chalk piece. All right, and this is where I'm using the Got To Be Glued Spray around over the top of the stocking cap. And this is just to make sure that the stocking cap is held in place before I apply the protective shield on top of the stocking cap. And from spraying the Got To Be Glued, it did make my leave out lines just kind of disappear a bit. So I'm going to be going back in and just applying the chalk that I used to make sure that it shows up well for where my leave out will be at. Here is where I'll be going in and applying the protective shield. And this is going to be able to protect my hair underneath the stocking cap. And I've, before purchasing this, I did hear a lot of different opinions on it, that this makes your head itch, but it doesn't really do that for me. I mean, it works pretty well, and using this, of course, with anything covering over your hair underneath is going to itch, but it's not to the extreme for me. This works pretty good for me. And what I'm doing next is blow drying to make sure that protective shield is completely dry on the stocking cap before I go in and start applying the tracks. All right, now time to apply the tracks, and you want to start with your 10-inch pack of hair first. Okay, so now we're going to be going in with the 12-inch hair. So I only used half of the 10-inch pack of hair, you guys. And this is how much of the 10-inch I have left. And then I'll start using the 12-inch. And yeah, this is the part of the video where I was trying to hype myself up because it is 3 o'clock in the morning that I was doing my hair. So my energy level was getting pretty low. So now that I've reached the top of my head where my leave out is at, I'm going to undo my leave out, and this is where I'll be going in and just making sure that I don't need any additional tracks, which I did feel once I combed out my leave out that I needed some more tracks. It's going to be actually right here on the side. I'm going to apply about maybe one or two more tracks here on the side. Thank you. All right, so we're ready to start cutting with my clippers. Here is what I'm going to begin the blunt cut bob look. So I'm going to use my handheld mirror to see in the back of my head and just turn around here and let you guys see how I'll start to cut. And I usually just start right in the middle of the back of my head and go from there with cutting and slanting down towards the sides of how I want my bob to be shaped. So I went up my hair really quickly with the flat iron. I didn't take my time flat ironing over my hair only because I'm pretty tired and I want to get a few hours of sleep before finishing the complete look. So I will be coming back on once I get a few hours of sleep later in the morning to show you guys, after removing my satin cap, how I go in and do my edges. Alright, it's now 10 o'clock in the morning and I made a satin cap myself, you guys, and I like how it makes the hair feel still really soft. And I'm just going to comb through, get it ready for me to I'm not going to flat iron it first just yet. I'm going to do my leave out first, like lay my edges before I get started with flat ironing it.
edges. I'm going to apply my scarf. I'm going to fold it in half here to tie around my edges and let the scarf sit around my edges for about 10 minutes. Work, 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 work. You see me heavy work, 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 work. You see me do me dirt, 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 dirt. Tell me about that work, 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 work. When you